business. You ready for some member updates? Let's go, baby. Jumping right in, we got a lot of things to cover today. I got this new little mic on. I don't know if it makes a difference or not. I can't really tell, but I don't know. The experts say that it helps. Friday Night Hype. Friday, August 9th. It's also going to be sort of like Rob's send-off party workout situation. All right, so if you love Coach Rob, be there. Be there, be square. So that means if you don't show up, you don't love Coach Rob. So I'm going to try to guilt y'all all into coming. But if you haven't been to a Friday Night Hype yet, come. It's a lot of fun. All right, we're going to have our DJ there like we've been doing. And it'll be awesome. More details to come. You know, I think we're going to do some food and different things like that. So more details to come on that, but put it on your calendar. We'll probably do it around 5. Again, we'll hammer out all the final details, but block it off. Friday afternoon, August 9th. Friday Night Hype. Let's go. All right, so second thing we got is the challenge. The challenge starting Monday, August 12th. And so the challenge is for new people. They've got 45 days to get in 20 workouts. If they get in 20 workouts and they watch the new member extra credit coaching videos, then they've got two options. They can either get a full refund and say, hey, thanks for the time, enjoyed my time, and I want a refund. Or they can apply that the amount of money that they paid, and they can apply it to another free 6 weeks, so 6 more weeks of Creed basically for free. So you can look at it two ways. You can be like, it's like a buy 6 weeks, get 6 weeks free, or you can look at it like getting 12 weeks for half price. Either way, it's just an opportunity for new people to dip their toe in, get a feel for Creed, get consistent with their workouts, and learn a few things, and then hopefully, if we do a good job at Creed and we give them a great experience, hopefully they'll continue. So that's why we do the challenge. But then we also have found that our current members like to participate in the challenge as well. So we up the ante for our current members a little bit, and we go, you guys got to get in 24 workouts in the 6 weeks. So that's 4 workouts per week. So I think it helps people get back on the consistency train. Sometimes we fall off a little bit, and you just need a little extra motivation, extra boost to get that consistency back. Because as we know, consistency over time is how you're going to achieve all of your fitness goals, whether it's body fat loss, strength gain, whatever you're trying to do. Consistency is the name of the game. So August 12th, if you guys want to participate in that, and we'll also have a little... I think what we're going to do is, obviously, you'll have to complete the 24 workouts. You have to get 24 check-ins, and this is for the one person we're going to draw out of a hat for 6 free months of Creed. So you, in order to get your name in the hat, you've got to do the 24 workouts. You got to check the box 24 times in those 6 weeks, but then also, you're going to have to go through the goal setting exercise that I laid out on YouTube. And so, more details coming on that, and we'll send you the link and all that if you can't find it on YouTube. So that'll be for you guys, for you current members, consistency challenge with an opportunity to win a free 6 months of Creed. Okay, that's the challenge. Next, we've got Fall Brawl. Go ahead and put it on the calendar. October 26th. Put it on the calendar. That's Saturday. The AF half is that Sunday. So your boy, I'm running the AF half. And yes, I'm going to participate in Fall Brawl. So I don't care if I'm a little beat up from Fall Brawl. I'm still going to compete in the AF half. I'm still going to beat Sam. And I'm still going to beat Dennis in the AF half, no matter what. I'm talking a big game, because what that does is that'll inspire me and motivate me and hold me accountable to get my training in. So I might not win, but I'm going to try to. I'm going to try to beat you. Anyway, that'll be fun. So October 26th, put it on your calendar. Also, if you are interested in being a sponsor for Fall Brawl this year, we're going to go back to our where we have four sponsors. We'll have a presenting sponsor, and then we'll have three premium level sponsors. For Spring It On, we did a different thing where we were just recruiting a ton of sponsors because we didn't charge anything for the members to participate or anything like that. And so it's like our 10-year anniversary celebration deal. So we'll go back to our normal four sponsors. And if you have a business and you'd like to sponsor that and be on the back of the t-shirt and also do have some different promotions at Creed, let me know. Because those spots normally go kind of quick. I usually don't have to do a whole lot of recruiting to make that happen. So if you're interested in that, hit me up on that. It's getting a little hot in this car. I need to speed up a little bit. All right, next we got, I just want to give y'all an update. We signed up 21 new members in June, 13 new members in July. Dang, that's a lot. Summer's usually slow months for us as far as new signups. So that's pretty awesome. Here's my favorite part about that. Out of those 34 new members, 13 of those members are returning members, which means somebody either left Creed for a while, they took a break or whatever, and then they decided to come back. One of the things that I told myself was, hey, if we have a gym where people leave but they come back, then we're doing something right. And so I'm kind of fired up about that. Anytime we have a member that leaves us and then comes back to us, it makes me feel like, you know what, we're giving people something that they want, and we're doing a good job, and it makes me feel like we're on the right path. So also, speaking of being on the right path, guys, the doors, all, I had a member today ask me, hey, is it okay if I give you feedback, you know, on the workouts and classes and whatever? You know, as I think of feedback, can I give you feedback? And I was like, a resounding yes, all right? Always. You guys always have, it's an open door policy for feedback. We want to give you the absolute best fitness experience at Creed. And if there's anything we can do to tweak the experience to make it even better, we want to do that, all right? So just know that. There's always an open door policy for feedback. Positive and negative now. You got to give some good feedback too, right? Got to balance it. Anyway, number five, coaching team. All right, we're recruiting some people. We've got Coach Mandy that's been doing a good bit of training with me. She's been doing a good bit of co-coaching. I've been throwing her in the fire a little bit here and there as far as like letting her go at it on her own. She's doing an excellent job. She's learning faster than maybe one of the fastest learners I've ever trained as far as a coach. So good job, Mandy. You're killing it. You're doing great. And, yeah, she's on board. She's in line, and she is on the path to becoming a very good coach. So I'm excited about Mandy. Also, we got Big Will coming back into town. I think he's coming back next week. He'll begin training with me as well. Will won Fall Brawl or Spring It On this past year. And a tall, handsome young man, athletic and very personable and all that. He's got all the tools and the skills that we're looking for. Not that we're looking for, quote unquote, attractive people to coach. That's not necessarily a requirement. But I could say a lot of jokes about that. But anyway, I'm not going to do that. Big Will, we're excited for you, bro. Also recruiting another guy named Andrew who interned at Spark. And he's got some experience, and he's fired up. Haven't fully decided on hiring him yet, but we're in that process there. So we got some coaches in line, ready to rumble once we lose Big Rob. We're losing Big Rob August 9th. We're just going to be so sad. We're going to have lots of tears. But we'll move on, and Rob will too, and he'll have a great life, and he'll be successful, him and Anna. And so we're excited about Rob and his next step in life. Okay, next. I'm starting to sweat in here, y'all. It's hot in this car. I had to turn you know what? I'm going to crank the engine up. Shoot. I don't care if it messes the sound up a little bit. I'm sweating. All right, whew, I that's better. Okay, now we've got, I'm going to give a couple member shout-outs. Man, I'm 10 minutes already, crap. I want to shout-out to John and Sean. John Freddick, Sean Stoltz. Two members that have been with us for a long time, Rooster Clubbers, probably two of the most consistent members that we have at Creed over a long period of time, killing it. And I just want to point them out because they both have been dealing with some nagging injuries for at least a year or so. But it doesn't detour them from showing up. So now a lot of times they're having to modify the workout. So what? They're showing up. They're checking the box. They're getting after it. They're doing what they can. And that's inspiring because a lot of people just sort of quit once they get tweaked. And they're dealing with some things that are fairly painful, and they're still showing up. So kudos to you guys. Y'all are really being a great example there in terms of dealing with adversity and consistency. So thank y'all for y'all's example. Also, I want to shout out to the Hamill family. Check out this story. This is pretty cool. So the Hamill family, you can find them coming to the 6 a.m. They all come together. It's husband, wife, Jason and Rachel, and then their two daughters, Caroline and Amelia. And listen to this. Their son just went into the Navy to boot camp. And they made a promise to their son that, hey, if he was going to be getting his butt kicked and getting into shape, that they would do the same thing. And I was like, you know what? That is so cool. So, you know, you can't have your cell phone when you're at boot camp or anything. So they're like taking selfies of each other after the workout together. And they're like mailing him these pictures and writing him letters and stuff. And, you know, they're upholding their end of the deal where they're like, hey, we're going to get fit too. You know, we're going to do this as a family. So I'm very inspired by that. I thought that was a really cool story. And I want to share that story with the rest of the creators. So give them a high five, give them a fist bump, because I know y'all are probably inspired by that story as well. It's pretty cool. Okay. Lastly, I had a quick question about pre-workout. So pre-workouts are kind of, I think fitness people get marketed to a lot with, whether we're on Instagram or Facebook or whatever. They hit us up with the ads. Somehow they figure out that we're into fitness, and they start blowing us up on all these supplements and stuff. Here's the thing about pre-workouts, a pre-workout supplement. You don't need one. You don't really need one, right? But some people like them. Some people like to use a pre-workout. If your nutrition's on point, you shouldn't need one, right? If you've got enough energy and you're eating properly, and you're eating just a little bit before a workout, not a ton. You don't want to eat too heavy. You definitely don't want to eat a lot of fat, because fat is a little bit harder for the body to digest. And so you want something more of like a simple carb, simple sugar, like, you know, maybe a fruit or even half a fruit, something like that. Something just to give you a little boost. If your tolerance is okay, you could have a little bit of protein, something with a little bit of protein in it. But you definitely want to go like no fat. And if you have protein, not a ton. And then more like a carb, simple sugar, something like that. So that in combination with a well-rounded nutrition regimen, and you shouldn't need a whole lot of boost pre-workout. But if you just like them, if you just want them, try one. We got a good one at Creed called Smart Energy. Try that one. A lot of people like that one. It gives you a little bit of punch, but it doesn't jack you all up like a Red Bull or a Monster drink or something like that. So try those out. Okay, gang, we're 14 minutes in. I got to end this video, but hope you watched. Hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned a couple things. Thank y'all for your consistency, your effort over time. It was inspiring to watch everybody do the exceptional 8 today. Super hard workout. I had a lot of great effort from our morning crew. So afternoon crew, hope y'all are ready to get after it as well. We'll talk to y'all soon, and I'll see you at Friday Night Hype for Rob's send-off, baby. August 9th. Be there, be square.